This is Greater Media News.
Welcome to Greater Media News. My name is Jessica Mukoro. Here are the top stories. The Department of State Services, DSS, has said the plot to set aside the Constitution and install an interim government by misguided political actors is real. DSS spokesman Peter Afunaya, in a statement on Wednesday, vowed that the secret police will use all arsenals at its disposal to frustrate such plots. The secret police, also said some key players in the plot for an interim government in Nigeria, have been identified. Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity, Garba Shehu, said Nigerians will meet President Muhammadu Buhari when he leaves office. Shehu lamented over the level of criticisms thrown at the President, adding that leaders are not loved while in office. He said former President Goodluck Jonathan, who was persecuted out of office, has now become the favorite of many Nigerians. According to him, this same yearning will happen after Buhari has handed over to the next president. The president-elect, Bola Ahmed Tinubu, has petitioned the National Broadcasting Commission, NBC, to sanction Channels Television for breaching the Nigerian Broadcasting Code during an interview with the vice presidential candidate of the Labour Party, Dati Baba Ahmed. The petition was signed by the All Progressive Congress Presidential Campaign Council, Director of Media and Publicity, Bayo Onanuga, and dated March 30, 2023. The president-elect accused the Labour Party vice presidential candidate of making several comments that attacked the integrity of the 25th February 2023 presidential elections. On foreign scene, the World Bank Group's Board of Executive Directors announced that AJ Banga, a United States national, is the only nominee for the position of the next president of the bank. This was contained in a statement issued by the World Bank in Abuja on Friday. The news agency of Nigeria reported in February that US President Joe Biden nominated Banga to lead the World Bank, saying that he is well equipped to lead the global institution at this critical moment in history. Banga, 63 years old, was born in India and is a naturalized US citizen. It's time for entertainment and sports news. Damilare Osalusi is standing by. Good morning, Damilare.
Good morning, Jessica. Now on entertainment scene. Davido has released his highly anticipated fourth album, Timeless. The 17-track album comes 3 years since the release of his last album, and its first time is putting out new music since May 2022. Just hours into the album release, Timeless has already reached number one on the Apple Music album chart in 17 countries around the world. Still on entertainment scene. Korean superstar Lee Jae-wook recently dished on his experience with Alchemy of Souls, dynamic with his co-stars, and various anecdotes from behind the scenes. The actor also thanked viewers for being also patient and giving the show so much love that it became an international superhit. Proceeding to talk about the challenging nature of Alchemy of Souls and his initial reactions to the script, the actor revealed that he had initially rejected the show since it was so complex that he thought he would not be able to do justice to his character. The final episode of Alchemy of Souls, Part 2, scored an average nationwide rating of 9.7, marking a new personal record for the hit show. Fans are now eagerly awaiting the announcement of Season 3 of the series. On sports.
Silkay Gundogan, this is Jack Grealish. Alvarez, 1-1! A hot knife through butter. And everyone's bouncing up and down. The big boy himself, on behalf of the man who fills his boots.
Manchester City came from behind to dismantle Liverpool 4-1 at the Etihad Stadium to maintain the pressure on league leaders Arsenal. Arsenal continued their fine form after the Gunners defeated Leeds United 4-1, while Chelsea lost 2-0 at home to Aston Villa. That's all from my end. Back to Jessica for the rest of the news.
Thank you, Damilare. It's time for 2023 Greater Media Awards.
Good morning, my name is Obunya Sapphire. I was the financial director for Greater Media 2019-2020 session, and I won the award for the best reporter of the year in 2020. I would like to heartily congratulate everybody who has been nominated for the award this year, and I also want to urge you to keep up the good work and make Greater Media proud wherever you go. Greater Media, no press, no information. Bye.
An award ceremony makes people feel that their work is valued. It shows approval and gratitude for each person's good job. And it makes people aware that good work will be rewarded. For the past 4 years, the Press Club at Greater Tomorrow International College deemed it fit to reward outstanding members of the club. The highly coveted Greater Media Awards have been purposed to annually recognize best newscasters, best writers, best club executive, and many more. This year's Greater Media Awards, which is the fourth edition, will take a slightly different shape as students who are not members of the club, staff of the school, and even parents will have the opportunity of voting for their favorite nominees. But first, here are the nominees. Newscaster of the Year, Junior Category, Ajileye Adebayo Folashade, Marcus Jubilee, Osalisi Damilare. Newscaster of the Year, Senior Category, Adekunle Amdala, Ilesomi Temitope, Mukoro Jessica. Writer of the Year, Adenishin Abimbola, Akerejola Isumanosi, Ishola Lois, Sani Oluwasegun Nioluwa. Most Dedicated Member of the Year, a non-voting category, Adenishin Abimbola, Fakorede Damilare, Kolawole Oluwatosin, Eyigeodin Daniela. Club Executive of the Year, Akerejola Isumanosi, Ishola Lois, Mukoro Jessica. An online platform has been designed to enable everyone vote for their favorite nominees. Here is how to vote. On 11th April, the voting link will be posted online. Click on it to access the voting portal. Then check each of the categories to vote for your favorite nominees. Afterwards, scroll down the page and submit your entry. Kindly note that you only be allowed to vote once. Voting will start on 11th April and end on 30th of April. Winners of all award categories will be announced at the end of next term.
Congratulations to all the nominees. And that ends our news production for the term. On behalf of the entire Greater Media crew, I wish you all journey messages to your various destinations this week. See you next time. I still remain Jessica Mukoro. No press, no information.